Now, most of you must have heard about many women getting pregnant during this pandemic. I'm one of them. Today, I'm going to take you through my journey of pregnancy. Everybody is aware that yoga is beneficial to all the pregnant women out there. I would say yoga is the best friend to all the expecting mothers out there, and also not to forget, it would help during these trying times as well. I've heard that yoga benefits pregnant women. I can vouch for it because I've personally experienced it. The first most important thing for all the pregnant women is to stay active, and yoga is one part of it. In fact, mother and baby are supposed to have at least 30 minutes of movement each single day. You don't need to do a rigorous or strenuous workout to get those benefits. Yoga is all about focusing on breathing and gentle stretching. Pregnant women generally face issues like swelling, bloating, body aches, especially lower body pain. I did not face any of them, all thanks to yoga. In fact, I was so active during my pregnancy that I was a part of an intense dance choreography during my 7th month of pregnancy for a family celebration. And yes, I think I did a fair job. Throughout my pregnancy, my biggest fear was if I'll be able to cope up what all pregnant women go through, the delivery pain. I can't believe that yoga helped me to this level that my delivery process was so smooth. Everything just went so smooth and I had the baby out in just one push, thanks to yoga. So I would vouch, in fact, and I would tell to everybody, to all the pregnant women out there, please do yoga. This is amazing. It's just amazing. And now that I've taken you through my journey and I've shown you how this has benefited me, I would recommend few asanas that helped me get through my pregnancy and also during these tough times. A few asanas like Baddhakonasana, it's called a cobbler's pose. It is excellent to open up your hips. It is excellent for your swollen feet. It would open your hips and thighs. That is helpful during the delivery. Next pose would be child's pose, Balasana. It is excellent for your lower back. It reduces stress and anxiety levels, and it is very good for your hips. Malasana, it's basically a yogi squat. It widens your hips and eventually it will help childbirth getting easier. I also used to do Surya Namaskars every day, which helps in flexibility and improve blood circulation. Now I'm going to show a very simple basic breathing exercise that I practice throughout my pregnancy and will also be helpful during this COVID time as well. So I'm going to teach you Nadi Shodhana, that's alternate nostril breathing. Okay, so you take these five fingers, close three fingers in between, take it to your nose, place your thumb on your right nostril, you inhale from your left nostril, close your left nostril, now exhale from your right nostril. Again, inhale from your right nostril, close it, exhale from your left nostril. This is one such round and you will have to do it 9 times. Practice this every day. This will increase your lung capacity, will improve your blood circulation, and also will give you a nice glow on your face. I would advise all the expecting moms out there to not practice yoga alone, and should practice in presence of a yoga trainer. And secondly, always consult your doctor before you start practicing yoga.